what are exam day guidelines for NEET, what are NEET cheat codes, how to score 600 plus marks in NEET, what are last minute preparation tips for NEET, what are subject wise preparation tips and tricks, and what are important topics subject wise, and what are banned items, cut off, what all to carry to exam center. And also I'll be answering the doubts like what is declaration form and all this. So make sure you watch this video till the end to get complete information from this video. Okay. Now let's begin this video without any delay. Okay. So now let's see what are NEET exam day guidelines. Okay. So first what you need to do is you need to fill self declaration form. There is a form called Self declaration form is very important. Without this self declaration form, you are not allowed to attend exam. Okay, most of the students will have doubt. So why we need to fill self declaration form? Self declaration form is nothing but it will ask you, are you having any virus? Are you having symptoms of the virus? And do you have any flu-like symptoms in the last 14 days, and have you traveled from any city or any country, and did you come into contact with any person who is affected with this virus? So all these things will be asked in the self-declaration form. Okay, so the main motto of self-declaration form is NTA wants to make sure that every student attending this exam is completely safe. Okay, so self declaration form and admit card both are very important. And coming to this particular form, you will need to paste a passport size photograph. They'll give you a small space. In that space only you need to stick your passport size photograph. The self declaration form also needs your signature and your parent's signature. Okay, so all these things you must make sure before the exam day only. You have to take your parent's signature. Okay, so now let's see other guidelines. Okay, so you must carry your admit card, your ID card, and you must reach exam center at least 1 hour before, because due to this pandemic there is thorough checking going on in each and every exam center. So they are checking your temperature, are you having any flu symptoms, so all these things. And they will also scan the barcode which is on the admit card. It is best if you carry 4 passport size photos along with you for the safe side. So coming to the ID proof, you must also carry your ID proof. Okay, so coming to ID proof, now I'm going to tell you what are valid ID proofs. Okay, driving license, PAN card, Aadhaar card, voter ID or ration card, passport, these all comes under valid photo ID proof. Okay, you can take any one of them. Okay, so now let's see how to score 600 plus marks in NEET. Okay, so first most important tip is you need to attempt at least 150 questions correctly. Okay, so if you attempt at least 150 questions correctly, there will be high chances of you getting 600 plus marks. Okay, so if you are not sure about any particular question, or if you are not knowing the correct answer for any particular question, just leave that question completely, because you have negative marking. So in order to avoid negative marking, it's suggested not to take any risk by guessing. Okay, so next important tip is you need to concentrate on weak subjects on so you need to concentrate on weak subjects and topics. Weak subjects and topics. Okay, so out of 3 subjects in whichever you are weak, concentrate mostly on that particular subject as well as that particular topic. Okay, so and other important thing is coming to biology, just from genetics you are going to get 16 to 18 questions. Okay, just from genetics. So now you might be understood how important is the genetics topic. Concentrate on genetics specially. Okay. See, coming to biology, 70% of the questions will directly come from insert. Okay. So if you concentrate on insert, 70% of biology marks will be in your pocket. Okay, coming to the exam, first start solving easy questions. First, you need to start solving with easy questions because all the questions in the paper will have equal marks. Okay, so first you need to start solving easy questions, and nobody are going to see whether you solved easy questions or difficult questions at the end of the day. You need to get a good score in NEET, that's all matters. So first start solving with easy questions as soon as you begin the exam. Okay, so next, coming to the preparation tips, you need to concentrate on high weightage topics. Okay. See, in every subject, in physics, chemistry, as well as biology, there will be a few high weightage topics. You need to concentrate on those particular topics in the beginning. Okay. See, only these high weightage topics will help you to score 600 plus marks in NEET. Okay. Next tip is, don't spend much time on single question. We all know we have very limited time coming to NEET, and within that limited time, we need to solve plenty questions and three different subjects. So before going to exam center, only fix your mind how much time you need to give for one particular question. For example, let's think you decided to give 1 minute for one question. Okay, so you decided so for example, let's think you decided to give 1 minute for one question. Okay, just let's take an example, and after 1 minute you need to automatically go to second question. You need to not spend much time on single question. Okay, so if you are unable to solve a particular question in a limited time, in the given time, just proceed with the next question. Okay. So, and next important tip is, you need to think and answer. Think and answer. See, there will be a few questions. If you read first time, you will not know the answer. If you read second time, you'll get some idea about the question. Okay. So few questions will be really logical, where you need to at least read 2 to 3 times. Okay. Read the question at least 2 to 3 times and think properly and answer. Okay. So, and next important thing is time management. As I have already told you, time is very important. So coming to these particular exams, time management is really important. After completion of exams, once you come out of the exam hall, you should not regret for wasting time. Okay. So manage your time wisely. And next important thing is prioritize. Okay, what is meant by prioritize? Prioritize means you need to give priority to the topics which will help you to gain highest score. Okay, so whatever topics you know well, start solving them first, and whatever subjects you are confident with, start writing exam with those particular subjects. Okay, next important thing is, read question paper once. Okay, before starting the exam, read question paper once. Once you read the question paper, you will understand the level of the paper. Is the paper easy? Is the paper lengthy? Is the paper difficult, moderate? All these things you will understand only once you go through the entire question paper. Okay, so once you get the rough knowledge about the paper, then you can start solving the paper by allocating the adequate time. Okay. And other thing which I would like to tell is, don't panic after checking the question paper. If you feel there are questions which you don't know the answers, don't worry at all. First start attempting the questions which you are very confident, because you're not the only student sitting there. If you feel the question paper is difficult, even the students who are writing exam with you, they also have the same difficulty level of the paper. Okay, so just be confident, you're not alone. Don't waste your time. Important tip is read question carefully. First few times in a question there will be words like what is not, what are not. If you miss reading not, then the answer is going to be wrong. Okay, so read the question very carefully. Okay, now let's see what are need, banned items and dress code. After this we are going to see what are cheat codes for NEET and what is subject wise important chapters for NEET, and also what are last minute preparation tips for NEET. Okay, so watch this video till the end. Now let's see what are NEET banned items. Okay, so they are not going to allow any pencil box, geometric box, any plastic pouch, calculator, pen, scanner, etc. They are also not going to allow electronic items such as Bluetooth, microphone. Candidates are not allowed to wear wristwatch, bracelet, ornaments, caps, wallets, shoes, handbags. All these are not allowed. So now let's see what is the dress code for girls and boys. Okay, so for girls, what not to wear is you should not wear hairpins and bands. Ornaments such as pendants, nose rings, heavy earrings are not allowed. Shoes are not allowed. Track pants are not allowed. Any dress with heavy embroidery should be avoided. And fancy skirts is not allowed. Any dress with inner pocket is not allowed. Big wristwatch is not allowed. Jeans is advised not to wear. Okay, so girls, what you need to wear is better you can go for salwar, trousers, sandals or flip-ons. For light half sleeve tops, you sandals with low heels or no heels, clear framed power spectacles are allowed. Okay, going to boys, you should not wear shoes, metal bands, jeans. All these things are not allowed. Even track pants are not allowed. And coming to what you need to wear is t-shirts, sandals, basic trousers and spectacles. That too, power spectacles are allowed. Okay, so now let's see NEET subject wise important topics. Okay, so let's see first for physics and then chemistry and biology. The topics which I am giving you as important are having the most weightage. You can easily get 600 plus marks if you follow these topics. Okay, so now let's see, coming to physics, work, energy and power, very important. Motion of system of particles and rigid body, electronic devices, thermodynamics, electrostats, current electricity, electromagnetic induction, alternating current and optics. These are very important. And coming to the three tips I would like to give you for physics subject is, first of all, you need to remember the formulae. Next, concentrate on the topics mostly like heat, optics and modern physics to gain very good marks. And next is concentrate on weak topics. In these topics, whichever you are not confident, concentrate on them first. Okay, so coming to chemistry, first most important topic is chemical bonding. Chemical bonding and molecular structure. Very, very important topic, having high weightage. Okay, so next is equilibrium. Organic chemistry. Coming to organic chemistry, basics, principles and concepts are very important. And next is solutions. P block elements, D block elements, and F block elements are very, very important. Okay, P block, D block, and F block elements are very important. And next is coordination compounds. Coordination compounds. Okay, so these topics are very, very important. Now let's see what are the most important topics for biology. First most important topic is diversity of living organisms. Diversity of living organisms. Okay, so next is cell. Mainly structure and function of cell. Very, very important. Next is plant physiology. Plant physiology. Human physiology. Genetics and evolution. Biology and human welfare. Ecology and environment. Last is ecology and environment. Okay, so these topics are very important. You can take a screenshot if you want. Very, very important. So coming to biology, diagrams are very important. Learn diagrams in a specific format and in a specific system. If you learn diagrams systematically, you can easily remember them. Let's see neat cheat codes. After cheat codes, let's see what are last minute preparation tips. And what is NEET cutoff for this year? Okay, so first let's see cheat codes. First cheat code is avoid extreme values. So first I would like to tell you one thing. If you are unable to cross cutoff, minimum cutoff, then only go for cheat codes. Else, don't go for cheat codes because NEET has negative marking. Remember that cheat codes are applicable only when you are unable to cross the minimum cutoff. Okay, remember this point. So now let's begin the NEET cheat codes. First cheat code is avoid extreme values. What does this mean? Avoid extreme values means first, for example, let's think there are four options. Okay. First option is values 2, second option is 4, third option is 6, fourth option is 32. Okay, so let's think there is one question and that question has four different options and the values are 2, 4, 6, 32. And most of the students will think 32 is different from these three values. So let's put 32 as answer. This is wrong prediction. Whatever value which is very different from rest of values that you need to avoid. Okay. So this cannot be the correct answer. Okay. So out of these three only you need to choose one correct option. Okay. So you need to avoid different values. So in the given options, whatever option is extremely different, avoid that. Okay. This is first cheat code. Second cheat code is don't random guess, go for logical guess. Okay, so no random guess. Only go for logical guess. Okay, so first let's see what is random guess. And then let's see what is logical guess. First, I'm saying you clearly no random guess. Okay, what does this mean? First, let's see what is mean by random guess. Random guess means let's think. Okay, let's think there are four questions. Okay, and after solving first three questions, you got option A as answer. And don't know the answer for question four. Okay, but after solving all the first three questions, you got option A as correct answer. So most of the students, what they does is, okay, so as first three questions options are A, maybe for fourth question option A is correct. This is called random guess. This is absolutely a wrong method. Okay, these kind of random guesses you cannot do. Okay, head, tail, these are all random guesses. These are absolutely a wrong procedure. Okay, don't go for them. Now let's see what is logical guess. Okay, what is logical guess? What logical guess means, let's think there are four options, and out of four options you are confident that A is not correct answer, B is not correct answer. You are only getting confused between B and C. You are not understanding whether B is correct answer or C is correct answer. At these particular times, use your logical guess and choose one of these, B or C. Okay, this is called logical guess, and logical guess is okay to follow, but random guess is completely wrong procedure. You should not follow it. Okay, so next important cheat code is all of the above or none of the above. Okay, let's see what does this mean. For example, let's think there is a question and options. There is a question and options are 1, 4, 6, all of the above. When you don't know the correct answer for this question, and when there is one of the option as all of the above, 70% of the chances are there that all of the above can be the correct answer. If you don't know the correct answer and if you have all of the above, one of the option, you can go for it. This is all of the above rule. Now let's see another question. There is one question and there are four options. Okay, 1, 4, 6, and option D is none of the above. See, when there is a question and when there are four options and you don't know the correct answer for this and one of the option is none of the above, there are very least possibilities that none of the above can be the correct answer. Okay, if you have like this and if you don't know the correct answer, don't go for none of the above. This is very less probability. There will be very less probability for none of the above being the correct answer. Coming to the all of the above, there will be high probability for all of the above being the correct answer. Okay, if you see have all of the above in the option and if you don't know the correct answer, go for it. If you see none of the above as the option, don't go for it. Okay. Okay. So next cheat code is using elimination method. What is elimination method? For example, let's think there is a question and four options. Option A is 1, 4, 6, 12. Okay. Use elimination method. Try to remember the concept which you know related to that question and try to start eliminating irrelevant options. Okay, so for example, using the concept of this question, I am sure that A cannot be the correct answer, C cannot be the correct answer, and you have only two options left. Okay, now what you need to do is use elimination method. Elimination method is eliminate irrelevant options. Irrelevant options. Okay. Use the concept which you know. Use your logic and use your common sense and try to eliminate the options so that you will finally be left with one option and you can put that as option. Okay, so this is called elimination method. So now let's see what is NEET cutoff for this year. Now let's see what is the NEET cutoff category wise. Okay, so for OBC you must get 40 percentile and your marks should be in range between 133 to 107, and for SEST you must at least get 40 percentile and marks should be in between 133 to 107. For other categories at least 50 percentile will be the, and for others 50 percentile will be the cutoff. Okay, so now let's see what are the last minute preparation tips for NEET. Okay, so first important tip is don't start new topics. You have only last few days for the exam. It's better not to start new topics, because if you start new topics, you will be in return very much confused, and whatever topics you have already read also, you will be confused and you will forget them. So better don't start new topics when you have only few days left for the exam. Okay, so next is go through short notes. Whatever short notes you prepared while preparing or studying for exam, you need to go through that short notes. So next is analyze your mock test. I already told you in many videos, mock tests are very important, because once you give mock test, you'll understand how much score you are getting and where you are getting stuck and how much time you are taking for a single question and in which subjects or in which topics you're feeling it difficult to solve. All these things you can understand only while giving mock tests, only by giving mock tests. Okay, so whatever mock tests you gave till now, just analyze them and make sure you don't repeat those mistakes in final exam. Okay, so next tip is previous papers. I have already told you many times, 30 to 50% of similar kind of questions will be asked from the previous papers. I'm repeating my point. I'm not saying the same questions, but I'm saying similar questions. Okay, so from previous papers, similar kind of questions will be asked. So it's better to go through at least last 4 to 5 years of previous papers. Okay, so next important thing is don't study for long hours. See, if you sit and study for long hours, whatever you read will not go to your mind. In fact, you'll be bored of the subject whatever you are reading. That's why make slots. Okay, for 2 hours read a subject, 2 hours another subject, like that you need to keep shifting your subjects and topics. And also make sure for every 2 hours at least take 10 to 15 minutes break. Okay, make sure you revise thoroughly whatever you have already read, revise them, don't start any new topic. Other important tips are arrange all your essential things, that is your admit card, self-declaration form, all this kind of things, whatever are needed for exam, and put it ready the day before exam only. And next important thing is don't forget to take your mask and sanitizer. Okay, and however, a new mask will be given for you in the exam hall, but you must wear your own mask also. And stop overthinking. You have worked so much hard for this particular exam. So stop overthinking. Just relax yourself. You can do it. Just be confident. And don't discuss with your friends. Don't ask them how much portion they have read and how much division they have made. All these things will make you more and more tensed. Okay, so don't discuss with your friends and maintain social distancing in the exam. It's however, NTA is taking excellent measures to make sure all the students are safe, so you need not panic about anything. Okay, so yeah, future doctors, all the very best for your exam. After completion of your NEET exam, I'm going to make a NEET paper analysis video and paper discussion, and also I'm going to give you the answer key for NEET. So hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching, and all the very best to future doctors.